Do you have legacy systems that don't have a path to the cloud? How about regulations that make you keep data on-premises? Join Jeff Woolsey and myself as we discuss the best ways to improve your IT processes for on-premises and the cloud so you can have a modern, adaptive IT environment. Just a while back, I was talking with an IT director. And they felt that even though they'd done a great job of giving employees choice to work from home or the office, their rush to support work from home scenarios left them with some outdated IT processes. We talked about some quick steps they could take to improve their IT management and governance to make things more adaptive and flexible, simple yet impactful. So today we're going to explore some of that advice so you have tips and guidance you can use regardless of industry or size of business. Before we get into this segment of Inside Azure for IT, remember this episode is in three segments. If you want to see how to empower the workforce, check out my conversation with Tara Roth, CVP of M365 Customer Success Engineering. And if you want to learn how to better collaborate with developers, I had a great chat with Scott Hanselman. Now back to this segment. Joining me is someone who needs no introduction, but I will, Jeff Woolsey. Jeff, welcome to Inside Azure for IT.
Thanks, Erin. It's so great to be here with you. It feels like old times again, working together on Windows Server.
Oh, the good times, the good times. Jeff, I know you share my passion for constantly providing IT and the organization with the tools to support them where they want to go. You know, whether a small company or a massive enterprise with data centers, everyone wants to manage digital estates in a consistent way. As you mentioned, we worked together on Windows Server for years, and the number one question we got was, how do I manage a distributed environment at scale?
Oh, yes. This is a challenge I've heard for almost two decades now. Mm-hmm. Our users deploy Windows Server in distributed environments. Sometimes it's multiple data centers, branch offices, retail locations, or a combination of all of these mashed together. Now, in these environments, users would add management solutions like System Center, OpenView, Tivoli, or create or aggregate their own tools. With these solutions, users end up seeing only a fraction of their total estate and then have to deal with the complexity of lifecycle management. It's expensive, complicated, and worse, incomplete. Mm-hmm. It's time for an easier, better way to deliver consistent management for distributed environments at scale with the cloud. Now, admittedly, this is kind of a mind shift for a lot of folks. And I want to reach out to IT professionals and system administrators out there. Millions of you have made your career learning Windows Server and systems management in the past 20 years. For the next 20 years, you really need to learn Arc and hybrid. Hybrid administration is critical for your resume and career. Now, Erin, you may be shocked to hear me say this, but we are saying that we need to shift our center of gravity. It's no longer on-prem, it's the cloud.
Well, Jeff, I'm not shocked at all. Having made the move to the cloud myself, it makes complete sense, right? In the traditional way that's still near and dear to so many on-premises folks, the center of gravity is your corporate domain and data center. But everything is routed through your on-premise data center, and you have a physical operations perimeter. And when you do that, it adds hosting costs, it adds latency, and that slows down the overall user experience.
Exactly. You want to take advantage of the best of both by creating an environment where their center of gravity is a hybrid cloud model, not on-prem. Yeah. We're seeing users creating adaptive IT environments to span on-prem, multi-cloud, and edge. Personally, I see this in several vertical markets like healthcare, finance, manufacturing, and retail.
You know, Jeff, what I love about this, it's not an either or, right? We're not asking people to get rid of their on-premises investments or just lift and shift everything to the cloud. We're simply suggesting a shift, right, in that point of view.
Exactly. And the way you can do that in IT is by using the best tools from the cloud and bringing that down into on-premises workloads, servers, VMs, other clouds, containers, and edge devices. Mm-hmm. This way, you have a common set of tooling to make management of both your cloud and on-premises infrastructure the same. You have one consistent set of management for all resources, regardless of where they reside.
Okay, let's go deeper. Let's talk about enabling cloud-native capabilities if, say, that bank was on-premises, or even just use a different cloud provider.
Yes, it starts with Azure Arc. Azure Arc makes all your on-prem servers show up in the Azure control plane. Mm. Now, for folks that are new to Azure Arc, this isn't migration. Your servers are still running on-premises. We're making a representation of those in the Azure control plane, so you can see Azure VMs and Azure Arc-enabled servers side by side.
So where today IT can take System Center or HP OpenView and aggregate on-premises data to build that custom dashboard to see what's going on across the organization. But now we're just giving it, right, directly to the IT pro. And by Arc enabling all your servers, whether it's Windows or Linux or SQL, Arc will show all your resources running everywhere, right? So you can then set and use consistent policies and security and governance, consistent update services, data services, like all of these. For example, if you Arc enable all the servers and data you have running in Azure, AWS, in your data center, and in branch offices, you can use Azure Defender to get a security view of all those workloads. Azure Arc gives you that standardized control plane. Now, on-premises servers still have needs that IT has to address, like if you need to RDP into a server to troubleshoot or do certificate management or performance monitoring.
Now you're speaking my language here. So keep in mind, there's always a time and place to do this, and we're making it easier than ever. So for example, if you need to manage servers directly, which, spoiler alert, everybody does, we've taken our customers' favorite server management tool, Windows Admin Center, and now we've embedded it into the Azure portal. So you can do things like browse event logs directly in the server, enable firewall settings, do web-based registry edits, enable roles and features, all from Windows Admin Center.
I just love this. You know, I remember, Jeff, it was only a few years ago when we started the development of Windows Admin Center. You know, we dreamed of having stuff like this. And now that I'm in Azure, we've brought these together, right? And when I talk to customers and tell them about this, you know, I don't have to tell them it's years from now. You can go and do all of this right now in the Azure portal. Now let's take all of this and bring it into a real life scenario. When I talk to customers, they want to implement this, but it can get difficult, right? When they get bogged down with internal processes and politics. And so where do you see IT getting tripped up?
Oh, yes, definitely. We have all been there. So there's a couple of points of advice here. First, please don't get bogged down in a pilot. I see this happen way too often. You can't make a business case for something if you tried it out on, you know, a couple servers, one or two servers. Mm-hmm. That's just not enough. To convince the CTO, you know, you need more than just such a small sample size. Mm-hmm. This stuff needs to be done at the heart of your IT environment. The real power of this is doing it at scale. Mm. The power jumps when you're at, you know, 100, 200, thousands of servers and doing it all in a single place. Mm-hmm. Now, second, build your operations perimeter around the entire IT estate. That means hybrid, multi-cloud, and edge, not just your on-prem environments. You can take advantage of Azure's security services for a unified IT estate. Now, lastly, you need to collaborate. Get developers engaged to create an IT estate that works this way. Work with your data scientists, developers, and security professionals as you set up your modern operations, because modern ops requires collaboration. And Azure is a great place to collaborate because of the unified nature of the platform. It's literally what Azure was built for.
Jeff, I see it every day, right? When customers make that leap from pilot to production, you know, amazing things can happen, you know, in the environment. And to your point on collaboration, you really teed up the conversation around DevOps, which is the topic Scott Hanselman and I talk about in the next segment. We're going to show you how to remove barriers between IT and developers, and we'll make sure to link the episode here in the video, so be sure to check it out. So I can't believe how fast this is going, Jeff. We're on to our last topic. You know, I often get the question from customers, I need a solution to run my current apps, my existing apps, new cloud apps. Like, what's a great way to do that? I have all of these. And so let's talk about the options when you need to pool on-premises and cloud resources to deploy either Linux or Windows VMs.
Yeah, I'm really glad we're covering this. And that's exactly why we built Azure Stack HCI. It's hyper-converged infrastructure delivered as an Azure service with Azure Arc built in. You simply register your Azure Stack HCI with Azure. There's no agents, there's no scripts, there's no, none of that mess. It's just all included, it's all integrated. Mm-hmm. It appears in Azure as a resource, so you can manage it, monitor, secure, and assign policy consistently, just like any resource in Azure. And the built-in integration with Azure Arc automates log collection, governance, and policy. Again, imagine being able to deploy policy consistently from on-prem all the way down to all of your Azure stacks residing anywhere at planetary scale. And with performance optimized for HCI workloads and built-in AI acceleration, third-generation Intel Xeon scalable processors provide the compute foundation for Azure Stack HCI with built-in security. In fact, ESG recently did a study measuring the improvements of Azure Stack HCI with the new third generation Intel Xeon scalable processors, and I highly encourage you to go check it out. These are just some of the great results that you can bring into your organization today. Now, HCI allows you to run your existing Windows, your Linux VMs, but it also means you can deploy AKS on Azure Stack HCI so that you can deploy those same containers that you're deploying to AKS and new cloud apps on premises on Azure Stack HCI. And this allows you to deploy Azure services on premises, like Arc-enabled SQL data services, PostgreSQL, AI, ML, app services, and so much more.
Wow. So if you need help in branch or remote offices with VDI at scale or even your transactional processing, Azure Stack HCI is really the way to go.
Yep.
Jeff, I just can't thank you enough for coming on the show to tell us about the shift that IT teams are going through and how to create a more adaptive environment, regardless of where the resources are located. Ultimately, Microsoft has an end-to-end integrated portfolio for people, processes, and investment. Be sure to check out the other segments of this episode of Inside Azure for IT with Tara Roth and Scott Hanselman for more. And for all our videos, deep dives, and skilling content, head to azure.com/insideazureforit. Thank you for joining us today, and I'll see you next time.